Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So over the next couple of weeks, I want to give you guys an inside look into my own personal aquarium hobby. In today's video, I'm going to share with you guys how I moved my 540-gallon aquarium. Some of you might remember that tank that I built from over a year ago. Next week, we're going to take a look at my personal fish. Finally, 2 weeks from now, we're going to take a look at the details of my aquariums and how they work and how I manage them. Last summer, I came to the conclusion that I've been ignoring for a while now. I'm out of room. So up until recently, I actually took up my entire basement. I used the main space in my basement, known as our second living room, to film my videos in, as well as build my projects in. I then used the only bedroom in the basement to house my 540-gallon aquarium, and it took up the entire room. I also have a utility room where I housed the rest of my aquariums. So essentially, I took up the entire basement just for my hobby. Now that accounts for 50% of my house. I then actually used my upstairs living room as my office. So I decided to rent a large dumpster and clean out my entire garage and turn that into my fish room. So I started with doing just that. I completely cleaned out the entire garage so I can start with a clean slate. However, once the garage was ready, I ended up changing my mind. The initial cost of turning it into a fish room, not to mention the monthly cost, became extremely prohibitive. So instead, I was forced to come back to the house and simply use my space that I do have more efficiently. I calculated that if I simply rearranged all my aquariums, I could fit them all into my utility room. That would mean moving the 540-gallon aquarium out of the bedroom, and that would leave me that bedroom to film my videos as well as do my projects and use it as an office. Committing to that change means I would go from using 60% of my house for my hobby to down to 20%. So the plan was to build the 540-gallon aquarium into the wall and then line all the rest of my aquariums around it along the perimeter of the walls. I figured all that I would have to do is rip down the wall, move all of the aquariums out of the utility room, move the 540-gallon aquarium into it, then build the wall around it. There was only one obstacle with that wall. In the center of it, there was a supporting beam that supported the floor above me. Now, instead of removing it and looking into other ways of supporting the floor, I simply worked around it. And what I did was just place the tank right beside it. So all I had to do was rip one side of the wall out. I started with taking the door off and then rip the rest of the wall out. Obviously, I shut the power off to that wall before I started. With the wall now gone, I removed all of the aquariums out of my utility room. Now I was ready to move the big tank. However, I needed a new stand. I needed it for two reasons. One, the current stand that I had was only half the height that I really wanted to go with to place it in the wall. The second reason was it would be much easier to pick the tank up and move it onto a pre-existing stand than to pick it up, put it on the floor, move the stand, pick it up again, and place the tank on that stand. So that's exactly what I did. I built an entirely new stand. Now I built that stand out of 6x2 lumber. Now you guys will remember that I built previous stands out of 2x4s, and I actually used the exact same design as those stands, just with a bigger lumber, and I added more center supports. That stand actually only ended up costing me about $150. Now I could actually get the tank ready to move. I started out by setting up a temporary aquarium for my freshwater stingrays. So I did have a 50-gallon drum full of biological media that would have to sit for 1 or 2 weeks. I wasn't sure how long it would take for me to get help to move the tank. So I made sure I kept the filter alive by keeping it running on itself, and I kept feeding it pure ammonia. Now the next part was easy. Drain the water out of the tank and remove all of the plumbing. Moving the actual tank was not as simple. However, luckily I have some great friends that were all willing to coordinate their schedules to a time and date that we could all move the tank. On the count of three, we all lifted. It was much easier than I thought it was going to be, seeing as how I knew it weighed 500 pounds empty. I was certainly expecting it to be far more difficult. We positioned the tank in its place, and that was that. With the tank now in place, I simply set it all back up exactly the way I had it before. I could now move on to putting the new wall up. I built a new wall frame around the tank using 2x4s. I then screwed in some drywall and then added in a door. Now, building up the wall was actually relatively cheap. Since I was only needing a small section of the wall, it cost me less than $100 to do, mainly because I already had the door. Now, you'll notice that the door is actually upside down, and this is due to the reason that I needed the door to open. It was either install it upside down or go out and buy another door. Obviously, I chose to use what I had. After that, I painted the whole wall, and while I was at it, I painted the entire room. With the wall now up and painted, I could see just how bad of a drywaller I actually was. I'll probably end up doing a little bit more sanding and painting and adding some trim around the aquarium, but I'm in no rush to do that. The next thing I wanted to do in this room was to make filming videos a much easier process. To be honest, I don't even want to admit how long it takes me to make these videos. So if I can save any amount of time by cutting out simple processes, I most certainly will. So instead of messing with large stands and backdrops, I decided to paint the entire back wall behind me chroma green, which means I can still do green screen videos, but only now I don't have to worry about setting up any equipment. I could just jump in front of the camera and start filming, which makes the video process a lot easier for me, and I can produce a lot more videos. Now, I also wanted to add in some personal touches to this room. Now, I know a local artist that does amazing charcoal drawings. I contacted her and asked if she could do a drawing of my stingrays and frame it for me. Needless to say, she did, and I was beyond impressed. I chose to have that done for one specific reason. I thought it would be really cool to have some of my personal favorite fish that I own turned into art. I'm going to leave a link in the description to her fan page for anybody that's interested in having her do something for them. Now, I prefer a very clean and simple environment, obviously. But if you think there's something I should add to this room, or there's something you think that I should have done differently, let me know in the comments section below. So that's about as far as we're going to go with this update. Join me next week when we take a look at my personal collection of fish. I'm also going to share in that video a personal story on my journey to get those fish that took me 7 years to do it. I think you'll find that video to be both interesting as well as inspiring. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I definitely want to thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.